and Jessica.
Yep, what up, Mr. Trooper? Hey man, thank you Christina, thank you for these parking pops.
Yeah.
You guys ain't rolling with the Trooper, stop the hate and respect the gamble, man.
That's yeah.
Right?
Yep. That's right. All right. Thanks, Trooper. Man, I appreciate it. What up? It's the Trooper out here doing whatever it is that I do these days, delivering the world's greatest candy, sparkly pops, to the peeps, to the troops, right? Here's the old bus station. She closed down. No more buses from the bus station. It is Saturday. It is, as is almost always the case, later than I want it to be. That's a struggle that I will probably die with. I will probably have that struggle until I die, especially since it seems like it gets worse every year. I have this problem though, right? And I think some people don't have this problem, but I have this problem. When I wake up and it's morning and I am like, I feel super drained and my face is like, my eyes are burning and I feel like I can't get up, I don't get up. Maybe that's the difference, because I have noticed a few times in my life when I do get up under those conditions, I eventually start feeling okay. So, first things first, how you doing? All right. He didn't hear me. Believe me, he didn't hear me. First things first, I didn't really intend to come have pizza rock. I mean, I've been paying attention. I know the 20th anniversary of 9/11 was coming up, but I didn't really pay attention to the date. And I didn't quite realize yet that it was today. Until I circled back after the sparkly pop drop just to get some intro shots for the vlog. And then I came over and I decided to grab pizza rock and I saw the big flag hanging between the fire trucks right there. And then I was like, what is that all about? And then I realized, oh snap, it's 9/11. Wow, the green light is on, but the crosswalk is completely packed with assholes that don't know what don't walk means. This is what you call dumbasses in Vegas that don't know what don't walk means. You can hit me if you want to and you'll find out what the fuck happens. That was a pretty cool display with the flag, Old Glory, as it's called. I'm gonna end up crashing if I don't get out of this little pothole right here. All right, this red light don't mean jack shit to me. So yeah, that was pretty cool. I just happened upon that little, I don't know what you would call that, not a celebration, a memorial of sorts or whatever for 9/11. That was actually nice to see. Pretty good choice of food too, because pizza may be Italian, but pizza rock? Oh, that's American right there. So I can't really, that's so weird. There's a balloon, you know those, shiny balloons like you buy that say happy birthday and shit. There's a blue one floating right there, right? But it came up from the palm trees, and as it was coming up, I heard the sound of a helicopter over there. I thought it was like a drone or some kind of little flying thing. What was I going to say? I was going to say, I said yes to a bunch of sparkly pop drops, and they're spread out all over the tourist area of Vegas, starting with downtown, now at the Palazzo, later somewhere, I don't even know. If you're gonna get to where you're trying to go on a boosted board on a Saturday night in Vegas, you basically have to decide, I don't give a f- tonight, I don't give a f-. Yo, shout out to Todd, who I just dropped off the Sparkly Pops to, and we gotta check out the phone because I have one more drop to make. We don't have contact yet. So what should we do between now and then? You know what I really need? I'm gonna tell you what I need. You wanna know what I need? I need a damn, what time is it? 9 o'clock. I need a mango dragon fruit lemonade. I wonder if I can get to Cosmo alive. Venti mango dragon fruit lemonade action. I actually got a brain freeze. I drank it so fast. Brain freeze action. Speaking of 9/11, you know, I mean, I know the day comes and goes every year, and I know that there are people that 9/11 hit harder than I was hit personally, because I was in Myrtle Beach. I wasn't anywhere near New York City, nor did I know anyone anywhere near New York City. But I had been to New York City. I had visited. I went to see Iron Maiden there in the year 2000, almost exactly a year before, because it was August of 2000 that I was in New York with my buddy Darren Milburn. What up, Milburn? I know he's not watching this, but I'm just saying, Milburn. We went to see Iron Maiden on the Brave New World tour. I mean, I still have pictures that I took from the top of the World Trade Center. But see, it doesn't matter if you were in New York that day, or if you live in New York. I mean, sure, if you live in New York, you feel it harder, but if you're an American, you should have felt 9/11, 2001. It's weird that it's been 20 years. Really weird. I didn't even put that together. I mean, every year I see 9/11 anniversary, this and that and the other, but I didn't really put together that this was 20 years, and I didn't even know it was today until it was tonight. I don't know, it's interesting to remember where I was on that day. I lived in Myrtle Beach. I was working at that coffee house, the living room coffee bar and used books. And I basically went to work there every morning at, I want to say 5:30. We opened at 6 and I was the only guy there from like 6 a.m. till 9 a.m. And I remember being there that morning and I was hearing about it on the radio, and all I really remember is listening to it on the radio in the coffee shop. And then when I remember going home, I don't remember if we closed earlier, if I went home early or anything of that nature. I don't even remember. All I remember is that when I did get home, all I did was watch news and TV all night, late into the night, and just being completely freaked out, like, what's next? You know, it seemed like such an elaborate plot. Is there more coming, and what's it gonna be, and what's gonna happen in the coming days, and what's the world gonna be like after this day? There was a lot to freak out about. There was a lot to be scared of. Probably every single one of you probably all remember your 9/11/01. If you're in America, you absolutely remember it, unless you were too young to remember it. Unfortunately, I failed to connect with one of my sparkly pop drops tonight. There's a 99.999999999999997% chance that I'll connect with them tomorrow. For some reason, I have found myself feeling extremely tired. I think that I am going to forego poker for the night. You know, even though I am super annoyed by some of the shit Howard Stern says these days, I'm a fan of the Howard Stern show. I used to watch the E! Show back in like 99. And the funny thing is that I would listen to Howard Stern when I was working at the coffee shop. And these days, Howard Stern's broadcast on 9/11/01 was highly regarded by a lot of people as being super informative, because he stayed there in the station and kept broadcasting even with everything that was happening on 9/11. He stayed on the air. But the funny thing is, I have absolutely no memory of listening to Howard that morning. It would have been cool if I could have listened to Howard Stern that morning of 9/11, because you can see it on YouTube now. You can watch the entire broadcast as the things were happening live, and they were talking about it, and, you know, talking about what they were thinking and what was going on, and hearing from phone calls from people and all this kind of stuff. So yeah, that's my 9/11/01 story. What's yours? I mean, I'm not asking you to type it out in the comments, but if you want to, you could. It's more of a rhetorical question. Where were you when you found out what was going on? That's gonna do it. I had every intention of playing poker tonight, and I'm not feeling it now. I feel super tired, and I'm over 9/11/21. Except for the part after I get out of the shower when I get home and I crack open WSOP.com. I don't know, maybe drink iced tea, maybe watch YouTube videos and play online poker. Remember, if you like my videos, click the thumbs up button, make sure you subscribe, tell your friends about the videos, and leave a comment down below. Damn bicycle security, they got nothing to do. I'll see you next time.